Ham and Swiss at home. Not as interesting or fun as Dirt Dog and shit. That's why I eat on the strip. But today, Trooper, yo, today is Sunday and it is 2:47 in the PM and I'm on my way to the strip. And by the way, I forgot to give a shout out to Nason. I forgot to give a shout out to Nason. I mean, Jason and Nick from Detroit, who came by Excalibur and got a hat from me yesterday. And do I need this? I always need this. And yeah. Okay, I'm ready. Ladies, ha! What? Got a little New York parking garage action going. Oh shit, it just got dark, didn't it? Sorry you had a ham and cheese sandwich at home. Don't need to get food, but I don't even know why I parked here, but I do know why I parked here, but I don't even know if I'm gonna play poker around here. I saw a video on Facebook the other day and I've been curious ever since. I wanna check something out. Keep in mind, when I go check something out for the first time, the first few seconds when I walk up to an establishment can absolutely determine whether I go through with the experience or whether I decide I hate the place forever. If the person working there is picking their nose as I approach, you best believe I'm done forever. By the way, in true trooper fashion, I parked across the street from the place where I'm going because I just didn't want to be in traffic anymore. Poker room here at MGM looks about as slow and miserable as it ever has. Just thought I'd take a peek. I'm not here for poker. I'm here for something much more important. So what I'm looking for, I have no idea where it is. There are two main locations where I'm gonna check. This one and another one. So far, I'm not seeing it over here. There's a bunch of television shit back here. It's called Television City. Don't they know television is almost dead? Almost. I'm helping to kill it. I'm okay with that. This is the other spot where I'm thinking it might be. Might. Might's on a chicken's ass. I know, but it still might be down here. Yep, I see it. It's all the way in the back over here. What a horrible location for a business. I mean, you're getting some foot traffic, people that drive here, employees and stuff, but nobody else. All right, so it's this mini donut place and they make them. They make them right when you order them. They go into the grease or whatever. And then they squirt stuff on top of them or whatever. But somebody tell me, is this the same donuts I got, mini donuts I got in Cincinnati? Turns out this is a franchise, but this is the first store that is like brick and mortar. Every other Dapper Donut is a truck. So somebody tell me, so I don't have to look it up, was the food truck that I went to in Cincinnati where I got the little donuts, was that the Dapper Donut? I think it was. Anyway, I said screw it and got coffee and donuts because why not? They got the friggin' heat on too hot at MGM. I had to come outside and walk. It was friggin' hot in there. The It's nice out here though. You hear those birds? I know one of them's gonna shit on me. Isn't that supposed to be good luck though? I don't wanna find out, honestly. By the way, as you can tell, the girl working at Dapper Donut was not picking her nose when I walked up. In fact, she was extremely sweet and friendly. I'm not usually in the market for donuts, but I'd go back there because of her. Blueberry lemon. Sin City, which is cinnamon and vanilla. Yes. So the question now becomes, where do I play poker tonight? You know what? I think I might be in the mood for Planet Hollywood. Now that we've established that, the question becomes, how do we get there? So I think what we do is we walk around the park into Monte Carlo, through Monte Carlo, up to the tram, take the tram to Bellagio, then cross the street to Planet Hollywood. Yeah? Or do we just walk outside? Seems like a long ass walk. For some reason I always think it's a long walk from New York to Planet Hollywood. Maybe it's not. You can see that they're removing the Monte Carlo signs. I mean, when is enough blue cheese enough? Holy shit. Can I get a burger with my blue cheese? Time like this, grab a coffee, play poker. I was gonna say and chill, but no chill. Yo, what, say what up to Token.
What's going on?
Where you from? Michigan?
Michigan.
Dead Tom's brother?
Yeah, that's right.
The dude that I ran into on the bridge with all the trooper hoodies and shit on the other night or whatever. Dead Tom's brother. Hi, Angela, Riley, and Reagan. Yo, Planet Hollywood was super boring tonight. I tried, I stuck with it, I stayed in the game. I ended up winning $103. The weather out here is unbelievable. I absolutely love it. It's almost the perfect temperature. Kinda like, almost. So I just saw a bum. Well, I should say he appears to be a bum. I don't know if he really is a bum. But I think what he's doing probably makes him that anyway, but that's beside the point. He was holding a sign that said, spare a nug? Question mark. Now, without Googling it, I'm not 100% sure what that means, but I'm gonna assume it means something to do with drugs. Let me Google it real quick. Thank you, Google, for confirming my suspicions. How you doing? For confirming my suspicions, a nug, according to Google, is a piece of marijuana. A piece of marijuana? That sounds like a strange way to put it, but anyway, the point was, when I saw the dude's sign at first, I thought it said, spare a hug. And I was like, oh, that's actually kind of nice. Then I saw that it said, nug. Then I assumed it was drugs. Now that I've confirmed my suspicions, I can tell you I'll preface this by saying it is not up to me to decide what people want to do with their lives and what makes them happy. If it makes you happy to sit on a bridge in Las Vegas with a sign that says spare a nug, then I say more power to you. You're living the dream. And I'm not being sarcastic, I'm being legit serious. Not everybody wants what everybody thinks that everyone should want. That being said, I have a feeling he's not happy doing that. And some people may see those signs that say, you know, need money for weed as like, oh, at least he's honest, I'm gonna give him money, or I think that's cool because he's being honest. That's a load of horse shit. The reality is that if you're not happy being on that bridge begging for drugs, then you should get off of your ass and work your way out of it. Funny thing is that I believe that's good advice for anybody, whether you're sitting on a bridge begging for drugs or not. Like, even if you're making 100K a year doing a job that you hate, I think that you should get up off your ass and work your way out of that. Figure out a way to be happy. I mean, just to be fair, and so you know I'm not picking on people who are begging for drugs alone, but I think I'd rather you lie to me and say that you haven't eaten in 3 days and you'd like to have a burger to try to get money for drugs instead of telling me you're gonna fucking use it for drugs. But hey, like I said, who am I to judge? Maybe a little bit of drugs would make the guy just happy enough to get through the night. So maybe it's not the worst thing in the world. Who knows? Aw, look at the tree. New York, New York. Why is a tree on the middle of the Brooklyn Bridge? Isn't it supposed to be a Rockefeller Center? No?
No.
Oh man, you know what I think I might want? Sometimes you just gotta have a little bit of square pizza. Just a little bit. One slice, that's all. When I walked into New York, New York, I didn't have any intentions of getting square pizza. But then I saw the sign, and it called out to me like a siren. Starbucks reference, kinda, not really, but yo. That square pizza? Really, really good. What the hell is this all about? I just had hot mini donuts earlier. Hot mini donuts? It's like a shack. Oh, it's the same place. The Dapper Donut. That big ass Christmas tree over there. That's a big one. Is that the ice skating rink? Is that what that is over there? I think it might be. Yeah, it is. Say I won't go ice skating. Say it. If you say it, you might be right, but I still want you to say it. Say it. I dare you to say it. Say I won't go ice skating. Most days I wake up and sort of struggle with like a little bit of anxiety on exactly where to go and what to do. Because there's like a million things that I could do or should do or need to do or want to do. Back before I took and I had a job, just a job waiting tables or doing whatever and was working for the weekend or whatever, I always had day off anxiety, what I like to call it. Like working 6 days in a row and having one day off and then I gotta go back to work. I used to have this super anxiety about like maximizing my fun or enjoyment or relaxation on that day off. And usually that anxiety about how to spend the day off would cause me to waste the day off and minimize my, you know, fun and relaxation and enjoyment of the day off. And now I have a different kind of anxiety, and I really don't ever plan to take any days off. And I mean really, because I do what I want to do every single day. And even though I may discover that playing poker isn't what I want to do forever and I want to do something else, I mean, I still have things to do today. You know what I mean? I'm still doing what I want to do. What was the point? Oh yeah, the point was exactly that. Even though I struggle every day with anxiety about what to do and what order to do them in and where should I go play poker and what can I do to further my agenda today? At the end of the day, which is where we are right now, I only have myself to answer to, you know? I don't have to explain to anyone where I went and what I did and did I do enough work or whatever. I am the boss. So if and when I get to where I'm trying to go, it's all on me. It's all on me. It's nobody's fault if I don't make it except my own. So that's the great news of the day. It's over. I won at poker. I had mini donuts. I had coffee. I had square pizza. Holy shit, it was fun. Remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. And we'll see you next time.